fiscal year 2019. I'm joined by the Chairman of the Joint Chiefs, General Dunn.
Our defense strategy recognizes the central challenge to U.S. prosperity and security.
You saw President Obama try to deal with those chemical weapons when he was in and enlisting the Russians, who now it shows were complicit in Syria retaining those weapons, Assad retaining them. And the only reason Assad is still in power is because of the Russians' regrettable vetoes in the UN and the Russian and Iranian military. So how do we deal with this very complex situation? First of all, we are committed to ending that war through the Geneva process and the UN orchestrated effort. It has been unfulfilled because, again, Russia has continually blocked the efforts. But that doesn't mean we give up. We work with the international community, the United Nations, to get the Geneva process underway and make certain that we don't allow this war to go on.
Mr. Secretary, you're recognized for any comments you'd like to make.
There have been a number of these attacks. In many cases, you know, we don't have troops. We're not engaged on the ground there. So I cannot tell you that we had evidence, even though we certainly had a lot of media and social media indicators that either chlorine or sarin were used. As far as our current situation, if, like last time, we decide we have to take military action in regard to this chemical weapons attack, then, like last time, we will be reporting to Congress.
We also want to examine how this budget request...
We're trying to stop the murder of innocent people, but on a strategic level, it's how do we keep this from escalating out of control. The department next released the 2018 nuclear posture review, which calls for America's... I believe there was a chemical attack, and we're looking for the actual evidence. The OPCW, this is the organization for the Chemical Weapons Convention. We're trying to get those inspectors in probably within the week. You know the challenges we face, where Russia has six times in the UN rejected and made certain that we could not get investigators in. We will not know from this investigating team that goes in, if we get them in, if the regime will let them in, we will not know who did it. They can only say that they found evidence or did not.
Thornberry, it is an agreement that allows us to balance both the needs of today and tomorrow, and to emphasize